I'm currently in the 11th grade, and I serve as the 2017-2018 captain of the Gold Squad. What it takes to be an E. Smith cheerleader is hard work, dedication, loving what you do and how you do it, and putting so much passion into it, nursing this sport like it's a baby, basically.
Our hardest challenge is pulling out the oomph that makes the cheerleader in a cheerleader.
Preparations that we're going through this year is, majority of the time, people don't think that East Smith High School will attend a competition as far as thumb shape or even doing traditional things like stunting, flipping, and so we are preparing this year for 2017-2018 to let everybody know who E.E. Smith is and that we can do more than just shake our skirts and smile and be cute in front of a camera or in front of a crowd. We can stunt, we can jump, we can flip, we can do all of that, and that's what we plan to show at the competition.
Hi, my name is Vita Felder, and I'm the coach at 71st High School, and I've been coaching at 71st since 2008. Well, for me, the biggest thing for 71st that I felt needed to be changed was that to just try to exude excellence in everything that you do. It's not about trying to outdo another team or outdo last year's team. It's about everyone stepping up to the standard of excellence. That doesn't mean perfection, but excellence, which is a big difference. Excellence means that you're striving to do your very best at all times. So I don't expect perfection, but I do expect excellence. Well, I do believe that the genre of Stomp and Shake is important because it just gives another side and take on cheerleading overall. Just the excitement of it, the idea of it being something outside of the box. So it's anytime you have something that's out of the norm, it's interesting, whether it's good or bad. And I happen to believe that this is something really great, especially for our culture. I'm just gonna speak from my own experience, and sometimes what I have seen is that when you're winning awards and you're going to competitions, you're bringing home trophies, banners, and all of that, you know, everyone's walking around with their chest stuck out. However, when it comes to funding, you can hear the birds chirping because it's silent and no one is coming for it. So what I found is if you're doing this If it's like most typical high schools that I know, you're really doing so much above and beyond what people see, because in order to make that happen, so much goes into it. And I happen to be from a school where, for example, my team this year, there's not like this big financial tree that's just, you know, dollars are falling out. So we have to work very hard with fundraising and things of that nature to try to further the things that we're doing.
Hi, my name is Tejon Cook. I am a 71st High School cheerleader, class of 2019, and yeah.
My name is Caress Golston. I'm a 71st cheerleader, and I'm a senior. Well, the most important thing is not every school does it. Like, you know, normally schools does traditional and stuff like that. So it's like, when you go to a different school, people be like, so amazed. So it makes me feel like, well, our team feel like that we're something different that not everybody's used to.
I would say my favorite thing would be, I don't know, I just like having fun with it, you know? I don't know, it's just, this, you know, the spotlight, the fans, you know, everybody just, you know, I like giving people a shot.
At our school, everybody loves us and they cheer us on and stuff like that. And it, like, so I feel like if cheerleading wasn't classified as a sport, that, you know, like when we have banquets and stuff at school, then I feel like they'd be like, what are y'all doing? You know, like, why are you not? So I feel like cheerleading is a sport because we're cheering the, you know, football line, basketball, all that. So why not be classified as a sport?
I believe that cheerleading should be classified, our form of cheerleading should be classified as a sport, because we go through a lot of the same things other sports go through. We practice, we have summer camps, and, you know, we train, we get ready just like everybody else. We still, you know, pretty athletic.
Well, nationals is important to me because, you know, you have like Queen City and all that, but like nationals is like the statement competition. Like, that's where you leave the big, you know, that's like the big bang in. If you don't leave it, then I don't know what to do. But, so yeah, that's just it.
Nationals is very important to me because my team, we're holding up a legacy of some very strong young ladies. And, you know, for me, it's all about my coaches. I don't want to let my coaches down. You know, they trust me to put me out there on that mat, and I'm going to do what's to be done.